name is Will van der Aalst, and it's a great pleasure to talk about a new way of analyzing performance in processes, which is combining performance spectra together with a replay based on a PetriNet. As this title slide shows, this is joint work with my co-authors Daniel, Vadim and Dirk. Vadim was the first to develop the performance spectra. He's being co-supervised by Dirk Vaarland. And Daniel Takke, genaamd Unterberg, was the person who did most of the implementation work of the things that I'm going to show. So without further ado, let's motivate why we need such a type of performance analysis. Here you see some, let's say, commercial process mining systems. What they do is that they automatically discover process models. And because events have timestamps, just by mining these processes, we can immediately see where the bottlenecks are. So we see what the average, the total time between two activities is. We can look at minimum, maximum, etc. So this is in Disco. This is a screenshot in Celonis showing basically the same results. Or we could look at Abbey Timeline. We could look at lots of commercial tools. And they basically all show the same. They make arcs thicker or color them red at the moment that there are bigger delays in a specific part of the process. This is very useful. And of course, all of these things are based on IDs that were first developed in the context of PROM. What you just saw were just some directly follows graphs. Here you see, let's say, more high-level models. Things like process trees, PetriNets beneath them. But again, it's the same principle. You see things colored red the moment that there is a bigger delay. You can also compute alignments on top of a PetriNet. And also you can color basically the process models or the PetriNets if there are particular delays. So what all these things do is that they show minimum times, maximum times, average times, variances in some of the plugins in PROM. You can even see the distribution between two different activities, but they fail to show the real details of performance behavior. And to explain what we are missing, I'm using the metaphor of looking at highways. So if this is a highway, then we can think of places in a process model as cars going from one transition to another transition through a place. And what is very important is that if you look at driving by car from one city to another city, it is not the average, it's not the minimum that counts. If you would really get insights in behavior and processes, you would also like to see that some cars are overtaking other cars, or that at particular times during the day there will be traffic jams at particular places. So we would like to see these more detailed behavioral properties. So if you think of queues, we would like to see is there a first in, first out ordering discipline, or a last in, first out? Are there concept drifts, meaning that the process is changing over time? And we would like to see whether there's batching. So many processes, work is first saved up, and then in one go, for many different cases, the same activity is being executed. Or there could be blockages. So all of these things we do not see if we look at a single number, like for example, the average time. So we are trying to tackle this problem. So what I just explained is that these aggregate statistics that I mentioned, they fail to describe these phenomena that you find on the slide. So we do not see tokens overtaking each other in a place. We don't see batching, for example, that work is being saved up and is done in one go. We don't see queuing behavior, that there is that thing that tokens have to wait longer because of the presence of other tokens. We cannot see drifts, the fact that the process is changing over time. And we cannot see that there are forms of partial blocking. So some cars can pass a particular point, but other cars get stuck at that point. All of these phenomena you cannot see by just looking at, let's say, these process models colored with red or thick arcs where the actual delays appear. For this, we need to have a more fine-grained view. And the fine-grained view that we propose are so-called performance spectra. And here you can see an example. So think of lines A, B, and C as points on the highways where cars are passing. And we are basically looking at how long does it take to go from one point, for example, point A, to point B. So TA on this slide can be seen as the event that the car passes, let's say, checkpoint A. And TB would be the time at which the car passes checkpoint B. So all the colored lines that you see in this diagram correspond to cars, for example, moving from one point to another point. In the context of process modeling, this corresponds to, let's say, two subsequent activities following each other, or two causally related activities following each other. And we would like to visualize this, and we would like to color the lines based on all kinds of perspectives. So what such performance spectra show that normal aggregate statistics do not show are, for example, phenomena like overtaking, as you can see the line here, or batching, that things start at different times, but another activity, all the different instances are handled at exactly the same time. And we can see last in, first out, and first in, first out ordering disciplines. We can see that there is a last in, first out ordering discipline when lines start crossing each other. Because cases that got into the queue later are being complete, let's say, at an earlier point in time. We can also see drifts. It's not so very visible in this diagram, but that you would see patterns changing over time and all kinds of queuing behavior, things waiting for resources, etc. So Vadim Denisov is a PhD that is being funded by Van der Lande Industries. And he, at an early stage, let's say, came up with this type of visualization to show the congestion in, for example, conveyor belts in, for example, airports. And he identified various patterns. You can see, let's say, some examples here. If you're interested in this, please take a look at the BPM 2018 paper. But the work, the early work that Vadim did not really take into account concurrency. So this was just a sequential behavior. And if you think about handling suitcases in an airport, this is very sequential. So the contribution of this tool paper is to combine these performance spectra together with token flows, where we are basically using the PetriNet to identify the causalities between different activities and only draw lines between activities that are causally related. Not because they happen to be interleaved in a particular way. So this idea is fairly straightforward, but it is extremely useful. That's why we wrote this paper and implemented these PROM plugins supporting this. So if you think about a token flow, it is basically a token passing through a place, and we are interested in the production event called eProd here, and the consumption event, where the token is taken away again from a place. So clearly, the production of a token for a place and the consumption of a token for a place, they have specific timestamps. And they determine the coordinates in the x dimension. There are, of course, two different scenarios possible. So we can look as a place and we could not distinguish between the different input transitions. So we basically look at any token being produced for this place and any transition consuming then a token from this place. That's what you see here at the top part. At the bottom part shows that if you look at the place, you can also distinguish between tokens coming from a particular transition and leaving for another transition. So it's basically We look at the place as an aggregate, or we are interested in all the different connections between transitions that can run through a particular place. What we can also do is we can color the lines in such a performance spectrum based on all kinds of criteria. That's what you see here in the middle. And we can aggregate things. So we can basically make time more discrete. We can, for example, look at how many times were, let's say, going from point A to point B in a particular time interval. For example, within a day, within a week, within a month. And then we can show these aggregate statistics. And we can see all kinds of trends. For example, things like conformance drift that we would normally not see. So here are some example patterns. It's a bit repeating what I showed before, but just to make the point. So this performance spectrum could show that, okay, activities are completely irregular. It could be that it is nice first in, first out, no crossing lines. It could be that cases that arrive at a point later are being served earlier, last in, first out. If lines are parallel, speed is constant. If lines are not parallel, speed is varying. If lines start or end in the same point, we can see that there is batching. If patterns change over time, we know that there is drift. And we can see all kinds of trends. For example, that the workload is growing, that the workload is stable, that there are certain peaks, for example, at particular times in the day. Performance spectrum can show all of these different phenomena. So after this, let's say, little bit of theory, let's look at the tool itself. And I'm going to show you a demo which is showing the capabilities of these different prompt plugins that we implemented to support showing performance spectra on top of PetriNets, as you can see here. So here you can see PROM in action. I'm basically selecting an event log. I'm also selecting a process model. After I've selected both, I can take them together and I can apply one of the plugins that has been developed, the Interactive Performance Spectrum plugin. Then we need to create alignments because we only have start activities. I switch that like that. And then we can see the process model in our new plugin. And we can select the individual places to show the performance spectrum. We can zoom in and zoom out in different ways. We can also adjust the height. And when we zoom in, we can basically, let's say, walk through the entire lifetime of the process. So what we can do is that we can, if we select a place, we can choose individual or aggregated, meaning that we look at the place as a whole, or we look at all the individual connections between the different activities. To color the lines, we need to add a classifier. And there are different ways of classifying it based on how rare a behavior is, how long it takes, etc., etc. So here I set the threshold of 3 weeks. I press OK, and you can see that the lines are colored accordingly. If I now change it to 5 weeks, then you can see that the picture changes, and there are fewer cases that take longer. Here I split it into 4 classes, where red is the fastest and purple takes the longest time. What we can do is we can adapt the visualization all kinds of ways. So now I'm showing the beginning and ends of months. Now I'm showing the weeks. I can switch to a day view. So now you can see, let's say, the 30 or 31 days within an individual month. We can also look at the hour level. So now you can see that the lines are really fine-grained. So we can show and adjust time in all kinds of ways. We can also show these aggregate performance spectra. We basically, for every performance spectra, we can choose the line view and the aggregated view. Now the aggregation is 1 month. I can change it to weeks. And again, we can use all the visual, let's say, things that I showed you before. Now I'm showing the behavior at the level of the day, and we still have the same coloring based on the classifiers. So we can do this for any place. What we can also do is we can add these artificial places, these virtual places. Think of them as milestones. But before doing that, I show you the, let's say, that we can see the difference between first in, first out, and last in, first out. So here, these crossing lines at the bottom performance spectrum is showing that in one place there is overtaking, in the other place there is no overtaking. And these are the things that one would never see by looking at just aggregate statistics, because they would be very similar for these two places. So next to looking at individual places, as I mentioned, we can make these virtual places. So we first select a source, then we select a sink or a target, and then we add this virtual place, which is represented by a diamond. It is not influencing the behavior. We can select such a virtual place, and we get again the same, let's say, interface that we had before. But now, rather than looking at a real place that is constraining behavior, we are looking at a measurement place. So now we see the time that takes to flow from the activity at the top to the activity in the bottom. We can add multiple of such virtual places. So now we see that there are two diamonds. I can also add that to the diagram. And now you can see, let's say, the difference between the regular behavior and the cancel behavior, and that this cancel behavior is there in the beginning, but not later in the process anymore. And also for these virtual places, we can also show, let's say, these aggregate performance spectra. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to throw away all the objects that I have in Prom to show you how easy it is if you start from scratch and you just have a log, you don't have a model. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to run the visual inductive miner. I took a log, I run the visual inductive miner, it has already discovered the process model. Behind this is a process tree, so we can see frequencies and the normal statistics. If we want, we can also see, and now I'm moving the slider up to ensure that we see all the behavior. Now I can, for example, select what are the times, let's say, in between activities. And the activities that are now most red are the activities that take the longest. I could also look at deviations, etc., but that's not the point of this presentation. Whenever we have a model that we are happy with, we can basically save it as a PetriNet. Now I can select the event log and the PetriNet that I just discovered, as I didn't model anything, and I can run again the performance spectrum. Just as before, we need to first compute an alignment. That's what I'm doing here. So we go through all the standard steps. Because this is a small log, this is fairly quick. What I now do is that you can see that basically everything that I showed before, I can do again. The key difference why I show you this is that it's also very easy to use this plugin if you don't have a process model yet, you just have raw event data. So basically all the different possibilities that were there before. I'm now, for example, again adding a virtual place, this newly discovered model. I can select it, and I immediately see, let's say, where the bottlenecks are, where the drifts are, where there is batching, and all these other phenomena that we could normally not see if we would just look at places. So I hope that this demo gave you a good idea of how these performance spectra can be used to show really fine-grained behavior inside process models. So let me show some more slides to basically summarize what we have just seen in the demo. So you can basically take an arbitrary process model in the form of a PetriNet, and you can take an event log, and you can run the plugins that we have. Note that the process model can have been discovered using some discovery algorithm like the inductive miner or the alpha miner, but it can also have been made by hand and imported from some other tool. So we take a log and a process model, then we can simply run the interactive performance spectrum plugin on top of that. And if we do that, this is the screen that we see. So what we see is on the left-hand side, we see the PetriNet model. On the right-hand side, we see the area where we can show the performance spectrum. We can then pick any place or a set of places, and we can choose between individual and aggregated. So if we choose individual, we are looking at how work is flowing from a particular input transition to a particular other input transition. If we select aggregated, so here we see these detailed individual performance spectra. If we choose aggregated, we are basically just having one performance spectrum per place, rather than showing all the different connections individually. So if I select that, we can see that there are just two performance spectra remaining, and one is representing the place highlighted in blue that has two output transitions, and they are in one spectrum. So what we can do is we can color the lines based on so-called classifiers, and there are different mechanisms of choosing the classifiers that we are interested in based on all kinds of criteria. For example, what the duration of a case has been. Then we can color the lines based on this, and what you see in this diagram is that the lines in red are fast, the lines in purple are, let's say, the slowest, and we can see this fine-grained behavior. We can fully customize that in any way that we want. Here I'm selecting two other places, and I'm showing these places because you can see that in one place we have a very nice first-in, first-out behavior, no crossing lines. In the other place we see that there is clearly overtaking. And some cases are taking much longer than other cases, and these are the cases that are also delayed, as indicated by the purple color. We can aggregate these lines, and if we do so, we need to choose a time period. Here the time period is 1 month, and the criterion is, do the individual lines, the individual token flows, do they start in a particular time period? So we can look at months, we can look at days, we can look at hours, we can take any time granularity that we are interested in. A very powerful feature is that we can add, you can think of them, milestones or virtual measurement places, indicated here by the green triangles. And these virtual measurement places are not real places, but you can think of them as a kind of implicit places, although they do not need to be implicit. And then we are measuring again the time, how long a token stays in this virtual place that is not influencing the behavior. And this way we can very nicely see how much time is being spent in a particular part of the process. So the performance spectra on top here is showing the total flow time from beginning to end. And the one at the bottom is showing the flow time related to the payment process, the time between, let's say, paying the order and getting a confirmation. You can see that they highly correlate. It's possible to zoom in, and now you can see, let's say, much better the individual lines, and you see, let's say, these phenomena like overtaking that I've mentioned before. You can also filter, and we can look at the cases that are taking longer than 5 weeks. And this is showing us very interesting information, because we now see some individual lines that seem like outliers at a particular point in time. So we can drill down on them, filter our data based on that, and investigate these cases in much more detail. So I hope that this illustrated the capabilities of the tool. I hope, and that I think the main point is that you cannot see behavior by just looking at averages, standard deviations, and these types of aggregate statistics. You really need to look at the individual behaviors of tokens in places to really understand phenomena like queuing, partial blocking, concept drift, etc. So I hope that you are interested in this tool and that you would like to use it. It has been fully implemented in PROM. It is in the package called Performance Spectrum Integration. You can simply download PROM, add this. What I should mention is also that it's very easy to use, as I also showed in the tool demonstration. If you're using it in combination with a visual inductive miner, like in 1 minute you have results. The plugin itself is also highly scalable, as you could see. The main bottleneck, as almost always, is in alignments. That is replaying these tokens on top of the BattaryNet, and this is a known computational hard problem, so in a way that is not so surprising. But in any situation where you can do conformance checking, you can also apply this plugin. Enjoy playing.